Welcome to Naresai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to discuss about one more basic element or concept related to functional programming. If you want to develop functional programming in any language, first we need to treat every function as a class object, and we required pure functions. And third one is higher order functions. In the last two videos, I did talk about class, how can we treat a function as a class object, and what is the usage of the pure functions. And especially in this video, I'm discussing on higher order functions. Higher order function means it will always allows function as a input, and also it will always allows functions as a input, either single or multiple, no problem. And it will always provides output as a function again. That means input and output of a function, again one type of function. Okay, then how can we understand this point? That means very simple. Let me design one program. By using that program, we can understand the syntax of higher order functions. Now, at the rate of functional interface, here I am writing one interface I, here one more functional interface, control C, control V, control V. Three functional interfaces I took here. This is J and this is K. Now, here functional interface means allows exactly one abstract method. Let me take M1, control C, control V, and control V. Let me take this is a M2, and let me take this is what M3. My M3 is one function. My M3 allows functions as inputs. Two functions it will allows as a inputs. IOBJ1, IOBJ2. And first let me show you functions as input. Now, how to define this one? Very simple. IOBJ1 equal to, for example, here M1 gives one value, M2 gives one value. Simply, here I am writing like a 111. Simply, I am writing like here, 111. Yeah. Good. Now, this is what your function for I interface M1 method. Now, one more lambda for M2, control C, control V. What it will returns? It will returns 222. This is what here OBJ2. This is what here J. Now, I told you higher order function means allows functions as inputs. Now, what I am doing here, K, OBJ3, here I am writing like what here X, Y. How many parameters it allows? Two parameters. So, first one let me take it is I. Second one let me take it is what here? J. Now, let me show you here. System.out.println OBJ x.m1 method plus y.m2 method. y.m2 method. Carefully observe here. I am writing one lambda. Lambda for what? Lambda for OBJ3. Nothing but lambda for M3 method. Here how many parameters it will allows? 2. Here is also. I am passing 2 parameters. Now what I told you, higher order functions will allows what? Higher order functions will allows functions as input. OBJ3 dot M3 OBJ1 comma OBJ2. OBJ1 holds what? This function. OBJ2 holds this function. these functions I am giving input to this function. Now let me execute this program. What happened? OBJ1 I am sending. OBJ1 means what here? This function. OBJ2 I am sending. OBJ2 means what here? This function. So we are sending functions to method M3. So these type of functions we can call as higher order functions. This is called what here? Higher order function. And a function which is going to returns a value in the form of again what here? Function only. In the form of again what here? Function. Observe here, higher order function means we are giving input to a method in the form of function, as well as we are getting output also in the form of what here? Function. For example, here I am written at the rate of functional interface, and here I am taking one interface, interface A. There is a method like a public abstract void M3. There is a method, functional interface. Yeah. Now, my M3 method return type is what here? A. Here, M3 method inputs are what? I and J. Those are our functional interface. Return type is what here? A. That is also functional interface. That means a method which is going to receive parameters as a functions and give output as a function. So that type of functions we can call as higher order functions. Now observe here, KOBJ M3 means what it will returns? It is going to return. Now here I am writing like, carefully observe, little bit of confuse, simply we can avoid. Instead of writing return directly, let me write like this. A OBJ4 equal to, open and closed. This is what here, let me take M4. Now we are providing implementation, for this interface by using lambda. So this is one function. Here I am writing like system.out.println M4 method, simply. This one I am written. Return OBJ4. Return OBJ4 means what I am written. See, if you observe M3, M3 having one output, nothing but return type and one parameters. These two are coming in the form of what? Functions. OBJ1, OBJ2. OBJ1 is one function, OBJ2 is one function. And this method, this one entirely replaced with M3. What it is going to returns? Returns OBJ4. Nothing but again it will returns what? Another function. A function which is going to receives input as a function and giving output as a function. Those type of function we can call as what? Higher order functions. Functional programming always recommended to programmer, better to develop the functional programming by using higher order functions. So this is what your one important point related to functional programming. Clear? So mainly here we need to understand something like functional programming requires higher order functions, pure functions, and the one is every function will behave like a one object, and there is no side effects, nothing but won't change the state. So functional program functions never having what your state. Basically local variables we can design, but once a function is executing, then local variable designer function by defaultly functional programming related function not supporting what your state here. So these are the basic concepts related to functional programming. So in the next videos we are going to see different types of lambda expressions to developing functional programming. I hope you understand this video related to what is higher order functions. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.